Previously, the group gladly rested overnight in Andralin. Zalar made arrangements to put the Wand of Orcus in a safe place for the time being, which turned out to be a good idea, considering Karxus bounced in the middle of the night to the surprise of absolutely nobody. The group had a heart-to-heart at Eris' prompting, with some people opening up a bit more than others. During the conversation, Iridian told them about Shema's death at the hand of Orcus that he'd been keeping to himself per Valora's request. Everyone discussed what steps to take next, and they contacted Malaya and Alistra to get an update on the Feywild. To their surprise, they were told that Eris' parents were locked up and she was needed so her siblings could figure out how to proceed. Nothrim headed to the temple where Iridian had been brought back to life, where they found out that Cal's resurrection had gone well, as long as their spouse didn't murder them in the aftermath, which seemed like a possibility for a moment or two there, considering, well, Ember. They spoke with Valora, who promised to make arrangements to get the group some needed supplies. After a pointed threat or two from Poppy, if any of them, by which everyone knew she meant Saris, were to run off or get themselves killed, the non-Nothrim people plane shifted back to the material plane. Nothrim then spoke with Mira regarding the Wand of Orcus. Those who call Andralin home were glad to attempt to destroy it, and Zalar created a new simulacrum to leave with them as thanks. The Asimars gathered some more berries before Iridian used Gate to take them all back to Amon. They had a day to spend to themselves before leaving for the Feywild the following morning. Once back in the material plane, everyone split up. Arian took Arif to the forest outside Amon, where he used his wish spell to create them a house. And then lost his ability to ever cast that spell again, much to the DM's amusement. Iridian and Gwei had a heart-to-heart. Zero went shopping, and Saris decided to put her low wisdom score to use and start a bar fight. The next morning, they received the items they'd requested from Valora, and then the group plane shifted to the Feywild. Alistra and Nor, one of Arif's younger siblings, met them in front of a crystal tree where they'd agreed to meet, at which point Arif was filled in on what they'd found out. Apparently, the city she'd grown up in hadn't actually been loyal to her parents. Everyone had been charmed, thanks to a deal they made with some type of higher being. Malaya, Alistra, and the others with them had undid that charm, and Eris' parents were currently locked up in the basement of their home, refusing to give any information about the entity they'd made a deal with, except Aerith. They made their way to the home Aerith had grown up in, and she went into the basement alone to speak to her parents. Her father explained to her that one of their descendants had made a deal with a devil, and then reneged on it, and their family had been cursed ever since. The only way to break the curse was for someone in the family to be born with powerful magic, at which point they'd be given to the devil to fulfill the debt. And her father, at least, believed Arif was the one who could do that. Her grandmother had specifically married someone with magic in an attempt to bring an end to the curse. It had brought magic into the line, but her parents hadn't been powerful enough. That's why they had so many children, trying to have at least one who was powerful. The devil in question was Mammon, who essentially was the accountant of the Nine Hells. It was pointed out that killing a devil wasn't the only way to break a deal. The wish spell could also do it. The DM may or may not have been looking at Arian and laughing hysterically while explaining that part. Arif explained what she'd found out and went back to talk to her parents some more as the others discussed their options. And that's where we left off.